लेज़ी एक क्वेयर राइट्स एक्टिविस्ट है, बहुत सालों से इस आंदोलन से जुड़े हुए हैं, एंड शी हैज़ बीन आल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द एंटायर टीम दैट हु हेल्प्स शी विल गेट सपोर्ट. लेज़ी,
I have the experience I want to share about the past 20 years. I have intervened in quite a few cases where trans queer people, where trans queer people have been in trouble and have asked us for help of some kind against violence. Or very often it is a case like this where it is, you know, wrongful confinement, wrongfully keeping someone in custody, restricting their freedom, and one of the things that I've seen, one of the things that that I have learned over the years, that in most cases, the kind of violence and extent to which families are willing to go against their own children. If you look at just this case, all the while you claim to care about your child, for their well-being, you are restricting their liberty. You are confining them in a room. You have moved them from their support system, which they have been in the US since they are 3 years old. All that is familiar to them. They are in a place where they don't really know anybody. They have no real support. You will not even let them out of the house. And you keep their travel documents with you, so there is no chance of them escaping. Escape karke kya karenge? You don't even have a passport. You don't even have an ID. Then, when the person leaves, manages to leave, and they leave a note with you saying that, I'm going of my own free will to pursue my life. You file a false complaint with state machinery like UP police. You are willing to even unleash UP police on your child, all the while you are claiming to care. What I have always seen is the willingness of the police to side with the family. Now, I can understand from the police's perspective, a family is coming to you, parents are coming and saying, meri bachi ki kidnapping ho gayi hai. My child has disappeared. Child is missing and I will be fear that he or she has been kidnapped. I can understand up to that point. What I do not understand is why is it every time after that the police feel that they can come and they can behave with us LGBT activists with complete impunity and completely illegal actions. I had help on Shiri's request. Because Shiri asked for help to come from Agra, from Delhi. The only thing I asked Shiri is, are you an adult? Shivi said yes. If Shivi had said he is not an adult, we would have taken some other steps. But any adult can ask us for help and they are completely within their rights to do so. They don't need any special rights under transgender law. They just need the normal rights available to any Indian citizen and we help them. Because of that, the UP police tracked me. I was traveling from Delhi to Bombay. They kept the track of my movements. The day I arrived back in Delhi, they arrived at my house. 60 UP police with Delhi police. They threatened my maid, who was alone at home with my dogs. Told her things like, "Gharwale ko thake leke jayenge, aapko jail mein dalenge, aapko Agra le jayenge." And she stood her ground. Then they went and told all my neighbors and the RW, etc., that these people have kidnapped or involved in trafficking of some kind. So I would like to say to UP police and to Delhi police that why is it that they collude with families to treat LGBT people as if we do not have equal rights available to every other citizen? If they just went by the book, we would not be have been in this position today. If they just followed the rules, you cannot enter anybody's home without search warrant. You cannot lie and tell people that we have an FIR of kidnapping against you, which is not a joke. Especially in Uttar Pradesh state, which does not even have anticipatory bail. So the point I'm making here is, this is only the penultimate of many, many cases I have seen with even more violence. People chasing their children with swords in Punjab. You know, people coming to the court to abduct their children and take them away. They have come to give a statement for the magistrate and for their own people. And I want to tell parents that, and I want to tell state machinery, that their duty is to uphold people's rights. People have a right to leave, they have a right to choose whatever the life they want, with or without their family. They can choose how they want to live, how they don't want to live. And the state machinery's job is not to give in to the deep-rooted homophobia, transphobia in Indian society. It is to uphold the law, simply that.